Is newer technology better than older technology? Today we're going to be comparing the Cobra RADSPEED XD versus the new Cobra King LTDx Max driver. Skylar's going to be hitting the shots, and we're going to take a look at the numbers. Hey golfers, it's Thomas Campbell, Master Club Fitter at Second Swing Minnetonka location. Today I'm joined by Skylar Kistler. Skylar, we're going to be testing some newer technology today.
Good, yeah, I'm excited.
Yeah, so we've got the Cobra LTDx Max driver. It essentially, it's a very, very long driver, but it's also very, you know, draw bias as well. We're also going to be comparing the older model, the Cobra RADSPEED XD. Both of them we can see clearly we've got some weight in the heel, so it's definitely designed to be more of a draw bias driver. We notice sometimes you have a tendency to leave that face angle a little bit open. I know you've been working on that game. Mm-hmm. But a lot of our viewers will also, you know, like, they fit into this particular model. It's a very, very forgiving driver. We're going to find out if the newer technology, the LTDx Max driver, is better than the older technology. So we're going to get some feedback from you. We're going to talk about the technology a little bit. There's a little bit of difference in technology. We still have like the infinity face, except now it is called the hot face. So it's still got the infinity symbol on there, but very, very hot, forgiving driver. Let's face it, this game's hard, but we want to hit the ball as long and straight as we can. Skylar, have you done much testing with Cobra drivers in the past?
Honestly, no. We've done one video a month or two ago about some draw biased clubs, but not a ton with Cobra.
Yeah, so both of them, the crowns are, you know, black, which is a lot of people like these days. There's been some different colored crowns with different drivers all over the place. One thing I'm kind of noticing here with the new driver here is it's got kind of like a matte finish to it. Now, I believe it's going to be available in a blue crown version as well. So you're going to have either a blue or a black. We particularly have the black version. It's got some nice and appealing aesthetics to it with some gold coloring. I'm excited to see the forgiveness, because that's probably the biggest thing I notice with drivers these days is, let's face it, I mean, there's limitations on how fast that ball can come off the club face. But all the manufacturers are pushing is MOI. MOI forgiveness, when you catch it on the toe, when you catch it on the heel, is that spin retention good, or is that ball speed retention good? And that's what we're going to test today. So Skylar, you're going to hit some shots. We're going to talk about the look and the feel. Let's get after it. Okay, Skylar, we're going to start off with the RADSPEED XD. This is the 2021 version. We do have the new golf shaft in it, though. So we've got the helium shaft that comes with the LTDx Max driver. 10.5 degrees aloft. Let's take a look at some drives.
Oof.
There we go.
Yeah, can we start the video from right now?
That was good. Nice shot there. That last swing was really good, Skylar. So the other shots were a little bit all over the place. Now,
yeah.
this is great, because let's just face it, most golfers that fit into this particular driver, you're not going to hit the middle of the face every single time. So we do appreciate having you on to, you know, do our equipment reviews and test how the clubs are performing against each other. So when you were hitting the RADSPEED XD, club speed was about 82 miles an hour, ball speed 116.6, efficiency at 142. So we're not quite catching in the middle every single time, so we'll leave a little bit on the table. But we're also testing the MOI, the forgiveness of these drivers, because these drivers are, you know, they're large, forgiving, and they're going to help you out on those miss hits. Even with your ball speed at 116 and your smash factor 142, your spin rate, you know, is still under 3,000. So that's showing that particular model, the 2021, the RADSPEED XD, is pretty forgiving. But I want to test now and see how forgiving it is compared to the new model, the LTDx Max driver. Before we switch over, I just wanted to get some feedback on that particular driver. How did it feel on the good shots? How did it feel on the bad shots?
You know, I've hit this club once before, and particularly with this one, I don't like the shiny finish. I know that doesn't have a ton to do with the performance of the club.
Yep.
But even just in here with the lights reflecting on it, it does catch my eye in a way that's kind of distracting. And I just don't get a ton of feedback with this club versus, you know, what I have. I've lost quite a bit of distance. I mean, that 140-yard carry shot, I can at times hit my 7-iron further than that.
Right.
So feedback-wise, it's not my favorite.
Not your favorite?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I will say, like that particular driver, you can get it in a matte finish as well.
Okay.
So you can get it in a matte finish. This is going to be a matte finish in with the new driver. But it can come in a shinier version as well, if mm-hmm. people like it. And I'm with you too. I think drivers, when they're shiny, it can be challenging, especially if you get outside. Mm-hmm. Outside, you're seeing that shininess. And I do like the matte finish a little bit better myself. Mm-hmm. But let's swap the heads and see how the newer model here performs. Okay, so I'm going to ask you here before you hit any shots, if you put that club down, now how does that look compared to the previous model?
Yeah, it's definitely matte, just cosmetically. It looks very similar to the Sim, honestly, I think, on the top.
Okay.
I mean, it has a little bit different of a shape to it, but I like the matte finish on it.
Yep.
But head shape-wise and everything, it's pretty similar. I think this one might have two, I don't know what those are called.
It's kind of like,
maybe
it's got kind of like
has?
Kind of like ping,
yeah.
Like the kind of like the turbulators on the top. Now this the old model also does have it as
oh,
well.
Does it? Okay.
But it's hard to see with it shiny. Okay. Yeah, so it's kind of like a reinforced speed frame essentially. So it's there for stability. Probably it's this way it's holding the crown together is what we're always seeing there on top there too. But it's probably there for a little bit for aerodynamics mm-hmm. as well. I'm interested to see how it performs.
Let's do it.
Boom.
Yeah, that feels so much better. it's a different feeling already, I can tell.
Well, one swing in, and we've already surpassed the other driver. So that was a great shot, that last one. Total distance and also carry distance. So good start there. Let's hit a few more. That's some pretty good ball speed there as well, too.
It's a little left, but...
Yeah. Little left, face angle was just a little bit closed. So this driver has hot face technology with it, so it's actually like 15 hot spots across it, so it really just increases smash factor and how fast that ball comes off the club face. So I think it also makes the club face just a little bit larger and a little bit more forgiving.
Oh, I hit that a little high. On the face, I think.
Yeah, I mean, for catching it that high on the face, the spin rate was, what, 3,000? It wasn't bad. Another good one there. That might be up there with the other. Yeah, 212. Good one there, too. That might be pretty deep. 230.
That's what I like to see.
There we go. Nice. All right, so the first shot and also the last shot that you just hit there. So first one, you know, took 194 carry going 222. This last one, 207 going 230. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So we got six shots up there with each driver, taking a look at the numbers. It's pretty clear. You can see you're getting a little bit more ball speed with the new driver. These are both 10.5 degree heads, both the exact same golf shaft in it. So it's quite surprising to see that you're hitting it, you know, that much better there with the ball speed. Launch angle was just a touch higher, but the spin rate was a little bit lower overall. So naturally, without taking out any mishits, your carry distance 183 going 210. I think this here is going to just show the difference here. You can see that yellow circle was just going a little bit further carry distance. And also total distance there too. So you said it felt really different. Mm-hmm. What felt different?
Honestly, one, I think my confidence with it. Like I said, I don't know if it was just cosmetically, the shine on it was just throwing me off that much that I couldn't really focus on hitting the ball. And I know my club speed was a little bit more with this one, but I think I was just so much more confident swinging this club because I wasn't distracted by the top of the head, truthfully. But I don't know, it felt not as dead coming off the face. I got a little bit more feedback with it. I mean, it's obviously doing its job. If you've seen some of the other videos, I tend to fade it or slice it, and it's going pretty straight, or if not left. So
yeah, you can see that you're hitting the ball pretty straight. I mean, with both of them, you're hitting the ball pretty straight. It was just you see that the RADSPEED XD, which also is a draw bias model, but it was just a little bit shorter. I'm curious. I wanted to see the curve. Yeah, so you can see 14 feet of curve with the RADSPEED XD to the left, something we haven't really seen much of from you in the past. Now we've got 21 feet of curve here with the LTDx Max, so just a little bit more draw. We're talking about 7 feet further to the left there. Club path number was basically the exact same, so good consistent testing there from you. Tech angle was up. It was a little bit higher. A little bit higher with a little bit lower spin. It's interesting there just to see, even though your face angle wasn't as closed as with the RADSPEED XD, it actually was drawing a little bit more. So possibly a little bit easier to turn over too than the RADSPEED XD. So if you're interested in testing the new LTDx Max or even possibly the RADSPEED XD, the model before, coming into our stores at Second Swing, we'll have both options to offer. We'll have the new drivers here to fit with. We'll also have the older models here to also fit with in store. Come on in. We'd love to help you out and improve your golf game.